Some people get every opportunity handed to them. Others never even get a chance. I love building, I love robotics, but access to STEM education wasn't a given.
I saw the same thing. Only a handful of kids got the chance. Others had no way in. That's what stayed with us. We wanted to change that.
Not just for us, not just for Singapore, but STEM education for every child, everywhere.
My mom gave me a Mars rover kit when I was 7. That's when the bug for building things bit me. And I didn't stop. Machines that moved, lights that blinked. I wanted to see how far I could push them.
I've always been a builder. When I was little, I took apart computers, cameras, even turned a disposable camera into a taser. I didn't know it then, but every spark, every scrap was me trying to make sense of the world. But something always felt unfair. Even in Singapore, not every child got the chance. Robotics teams only had room for a few, and most kids never even got to try.
And for the kids outside Singapore, entire schools didn't have the resources.
So I began asking, how do you make creativity accessible? Not just to the top schools, but to the schools with little to no resources. I knew I wanted to keep things simple. Tools children could build with anywhere. A classroom, a village hall, even under a tree. I asked myself, what's cheap, fairly strong and accessible? I was looking at cardboard, PVC pipes, anything easy to find and DIY. Then one day, I opened a kitchen drawer and saw a pile of unused takeaway chopsticks. That moment sparked something in me. What if we use chopsticks to build robots? These are everywhere, and they're strong and easy to cut and shape.
He posted some of his prototypes on social media, and I immediately knew I wanted to be involved.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay, got it, got it. Okay, so for the soldering.
Our stickum kit includes geometric connectors, wooden chopsticks, and plug-and-play electronics. We also have an app and an online academy, but really, it's a starter kit for kids to build hundreds of ideas from anything they find around them.
We quickly realized one thing. We didn't just discover a tool. We have created affordable STEAM education, as in STEAM. Science, technology, engineering, the arts, and mathematics. Problem solving, collaboration, creativity. Skills that don't go out of date.
We trained teachers who had never touched robotics before, showing them that with just a few hours of guidance, they could spark a whole new way of learning. And then we stood back and watched the children take over.
They built cars that moved, towers that stretched high, machines that could draw, even contraptions that made no sense at all.
But what mattered wasn't the invention, it was the joy, the pride in showing I made this, the realization I can do this. We watched children build their first machines out of nothing but sticks and some connectors.
It is truly amazing to see and discover what they can do with something so simple.
Today, our Stickum kits have reached 13,000 students and 1,300 educators in places from rural Uganda to floating villages in Malaysia. Everywhere we go, the story is the same. Potential is universal.
Maybe it comes back to where we began. Two kids who loved building, but who also saw how access to quality STEAM education wasn't a given. That unfairness fuels us still. We don't want a child to feel as if they don't belong in the future.
When I was younger and was busy building wild and practical things from scrap, my mom always asked me, how is this going to help the world? Now, with what we're doing, we can say that we are contributing towards a world where every child feels seen, where their ideas matter, and where their hands can bring those ideas to life.